can hear what you're thinking, all your doubts and fear. And if you look in my eyes in time.
The phone rang, I picked it up, it was Rod Culleton, and I said, look, mate, sorry, I can't talk, I'm flat out. He said, can we talk in a couple of days? It's not a problem. And that was it. The next thing I know, and a poster comes out saying, A1's joining up. And it was never discussed. It was never broached. It wasn't even hinted at. And so, as I said at the time, I'd have preferred to have a quiet conversation with Rod Culleton. We've made our position and our approach quite clear. We're not signing up with anybody at all. This is an attack on converging axes. Everybody earns their own right to fight. And then when we get to the top of the hill, we divide the spoils or whatever we need to do. And so we've been very clear on that. And for a whole bunch of rational reasons too, because as you know, we have a strict criteria for signing up, because if we expect our members to have a working with children's check, and if we expect our members to make sure they don't have dual nationalities, how can we then legitimately sign up with a group of people? We don't have any idea who they are, where they've come from, and what their real motives are. And that's not having a shot at anybody, because as I've said many, many times, we need as many minors and independents as possible. But that doesn't necessarily mean we hold hands and sing Kumbaya as we climb up the hill. And so it was just, Culleton blew his bolt a fraction early. And unfortunately for him and CADCO, and I wish them well, and that's fantastic, but that's just not the way we're fighting this war. It was just a misunderstanding. His party just spoke too soon. You need the minor parties to feed preferences to each other. But you've got to understand this. The system is so utterly corrupted that the first thing we all agree upon is put the majors last, without a shadow of a doubt. And then you preference the other individuals well before the minors. But that doesn't mean we have to hold hands and sing Kumbaya, as I said. That's not the way this works. Every party has to earn its right, because you've got to understand that this is a brutal game. And people will lean on you and ride your coattails and expect you to do the heavy lifting for them. This is Darwinian survival at its most, most brutal. And you've got to get up there and you've got to sell your policies and your idea to the people. Now, our view is quite simple. We're going to trounce everybody else. We're going to be the only game in town, because there is no party, no organization that's set up like us. We give authority to the people. They select their candidates. We have a full suite of policies. This isn't just about stopping the lockdowns. You know, that's step one in about a 15-step process. What happens after that? And there's a lot of work to be done. And so we're going to fight this. We're going to win this. And as I said, we're going to be the only game in town by the end of it. Come May, when the election is on, it'll be us and nobody else.
You can stick your corporation up your ass. You can stick your corporation up your ass. You can stick your corporation. We're a free and sovereign nation. Stick your corporation up your ass. Singing, we are the 99%.